Welcome back, everyone, to the final stretch of Final Fantasy X HD Remaster. I may mention that this might be the last session for the story, but I figured out a couple of things that I need to do in order to get what I wanted to get at Remiem Temple. But it involves grinding and monster capturing, so I may be doing that, and then I'll probably skip or edit out the monster capturing itself and just go to what I want to get. The prize you get for capturing monsters. So if you remember, the first thing we needed to do with the monster capture was capture every type of monster at
the final show
in the Calmlands. Actually, maybe before I do that, I'll go to these small places first.
Yeehaw! Here we go.
Because there are some treasure chests and such. Dragoon, oh, is that Kimari's ultimate weapon? Could be Kimari's ultimate weapon. No. But it is pretty good. I might as well equip these guys with their capture swords, because I'm going to be using that taming sword. Wait. I thought your taming sword had something extra. No? It was the Avenger that had something extra. Okay. Walker. Catcher, and then Auron. Beastmaster. I might get one for Kimari as well. Just to make things easy, I guess. So that's that. There's only one small section here. You might have seen this section on the...
The final showdown with Sheen. I say let's get this show on the road!
As you were walking by the Besaid waterfalls, you might have seen some of those treasure chests. There is another one. There is another one in Besaid. There's another one in Meehan High Road. So there are a few that I haven't gotten yet. Probably won't be getting them, to be honest with you. So I think I should be okay going to Mushroom Rock.
Here we go!
The thing is, like I said before, there are a lot of dark aeons and they're blocking paths in several locations, so that's somewhat annoying. Maybe I should have my map up just in case so that I don't miss anything. Yeah, see? Wait. Okay, so it's the bottom one. Wow, this is very claustrophobic. Ooh. Yes, sir. Riku's ultimate weapon. Yeah. But that also doesn't have any abilities on it aside from no AP, I believe, so not that useful right now. And I don't think I have any of Riku's crests or sigils, so I can't get anything from her in that regard.
The final showdown.
And Sanuvia Sands is the last place. Sanuvia Sands is. I don't really know if I want to go here.
Yeehaw! Here we go.
Let's go, considering I haven't been there before. Oh, this is just a treasure chest. Skalon, what is that? Is that for you? Oh, there's music. Sounds very weird. Skalon for Titus, double AP. Is that it? Really? Weird. Hi guys. Oh, I can't really get him to face the camera. Hi guys. uh, Yeah.
The final show.
Yeah, yeah. So we've. Yeah, I didn't check out what else I could input. Whee! Yeah. I don't want to really waste time. I'm not gonna go to the Omega Ruins, I might go there later.
The final show.
That's where the final Albert Primer is. The Omega Ruins. Omega Ruins! What is the Omega Ruins close to Bavel, is it? No. Where is that? Josie. I guess, maybe. I can't really tell what. Yeah, Guadalsalam maybe. No, not really. Moonflow is the closest thing. So, oh yeah, there's a whole section of all the, like, above that red dot right now where we never really went. Cool. Where did I want to go? So I should have now 5 captured enemies. I need everyone from the Calmlands and I need everyone from Mount Gagazette.
This is gonna be easy!
Oh my. How much life does this guy have?
I'm here.
Multiple status effects is something I do not need right now. Confuse. Let's have you now in the party. This could go well, or it could go very not well. Let's use some magic on it, I guess. 7,000. I think Tidus also has Confuse Ward. And armor. Yeah. Yeah, Confuse Ward. Maybe I can Hestiga everyone. Okay. He can inflict bad breath or he can inflict normal attacks. If he inflicts his normal attacks, we're good. If he inflicts bad breath, then we need to be worried. Okay, Yuna can't attack now. Okay, we should get him. I hope this is his. Waka has his capture. Yeah, he should have his capture. Marlboro captured and overkill.
I'm good, yeah.
Sweet. Sweet, I didn't think I'd get a Marlboro, so that's really cool. Yeah. Was anyone hurt? No one else really. So that's really cool. So now I have 6. And then I need 3 more and then I need everyone from Mount Gagazette as well. Which hopefully it counted all the ones I captured before. Skull, Neverus, Frameflan, Ogre, Cole, Marlboros. Marlboros are strongest. I need one more. I've got an Ogre. Trying to think what else I haven't fought yet. It's really hard to think about what you've fought and what you haven't. So yeah, there are 3 more here. I might buy a weapon for Kimari actually. Where's Kimari Taming Spear. Don't really have a lot of gil though. Maybe not. Let me save, and then I'll edit everything else out until we meet again. These guys! This is what I need. Wow. Vulnerable to threat. darkness and silence work well. Which means I need Orinin. Just let me steal. Ice Jam! I want a haste, so I'll bring Orinin first to inflict.
As you wish.
Thurple Foul. This guy. I think he's darkened. Not silenced though. Which is annoying. Let's bring Walker in so that he can darken the other guy. And then we swap Reku for Titus. And we haste everyone. Let's have silence, actually.
Be quiet!
I thought it was supposed to work well. Maybe I can threaten them since that's supposed to work well as well.
Do not move.
Huh. Interesting. How much HP? 49. Okay, how much HP? 46. I could actually probably black magic him. It's fine, that's fine. Yeah! Let's threaten him again. Oh no!
Calm down!
That was a waste. He was almost dead. Was that threaten? Threaten was what did that. Wow, threaten really does damage, I didn't know that. Too bad Lulu and Kimari aren't getting levels here. Formation, it doesn't matter. Equip Lulu with no encounters. Okay, so I've gotten all the monsters that I needed, at least one of each. The last one I needed was the Chimera Brain, which is one of those, well, Chimera looking monsters that has three heads, that has a snake head and two like beast heads. So that all worked out fine. And apparently threaten does damage. I didn't know threaten did damage. And it does a lot of damage. Because the one enemy had full health, I think. Maybe Waka hit him once. And he ended up with like 100 HP left after threaten, which is really interesting. I didn't know that would work out that way. Ah, you've got all the fiends of the Comlands. Now I can reopen the arena. Oops, I almost forgot. Here's a token of my appreciation for your hard work. I don't know if you have what it takes to open it, though. The Celestial Mirror seems to react. Yezza. This is Yuna's ultimate weapon. Yes, it is. Cool. I didn't even know that. Let's look at it. Oh, let's look at its abilities at least. No AP! And I don't really remember, I think, yeah, Yuna's the moon crest. Mars is, I think, orange. Saturn is, I think, Kimari. You have Jupiter for Waka. I forget what Lulu and Riku's one are called. What celestial name they have. I think it's Athena Skimari, I could be wrong. So I don't know what Yuna's Moon Sigil, where to get that. It'd be so cool if we could. So yeah, now what I want to do is get Mount Gagazet. Pop lane win. Not now. Oh no. So you've been patrolling, huh? In them caverns. Gagazet. Wow, I have areas that I don't have unlocked yet either. I know one of them's a Omega Dungeon. I wonder what these ones are. Oh, okay, yeah, I know what some of them are actually. So here I have, wow, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I know there are 3 underwater ones. These might be the 3 underwater ones. That's cool. Then there are 2 here. Well, I have 1 Ahriman. There's a was there an ogre up there? I'm not too sure actually. Bandersnatch, Shura. So 2 plus the underwater ones. Okay. Should I buy items? I think I'm good for items. Oh, that's right, Mount Gagazet isn't just in the cave, it's outside the cave as well, isn't it? I'm trying to remember what else. It's so hard. So let's save first. Maybe I should have fought that enemy and just like at least stolen stuff from him. Because I get to keep stuff if I steal them, I think. Alright, so let's go up to Gagazet. I could fly there quickly, but... Whoa! Shinryu! Oh, I can't bring anyone else in. Okay. Let's escape. Yes, I got a Grandal. Darkland, Ironman, Ashless. Yep. So it's the bombs. Grim fiends lurk in the dungeon of the traitor Omega. Can't you guess what I'm trying to say? Different parts of spirit are home to different kinds of lizards. Could you go capture some for me? You know about the hard-shelled guys, right? I sure want to know which is the toughest. Okay, so I'm back at Mount Gagazet and I've captured all but one enemy that I needed. I did a great job using the capture weapons here the first time I went through here, so I caught like quite a few. I needed 3 more for the underwater fires that I didn't fight at all when I was here the last time in the cave. And then I had one more, which was one of those, if you remember, the enemy that usually hangs around with the eyeball enemy in the cave that charges itself up. It's called the Grendel. So I got one of those, and then I'm left with one thing, and that's the bombs that I don't think I have enough strength to kill in one hit, in one go. So maybe Yuna can help in that regard by making them a lot weaker. Maybe even Auron can help as well. So that might be my main party to take on the bombs. Formation, let's change Waka. So it's really the bombs. I believe it's the bombs are the only ones that are left, because I never captured any bombs. I never was able to kill them. They always self-destructed. And you also have to bear in mind that they count. So unlike the mech enemies that don't count, that can't be captured, bombs can be captured. So they must be the ones. So I'm going to run up here quickly. And then I'm going to unequip Lulu and hope for some bombs. No, not these guys.
That won't go so easy on you next time.
Yeah, I'll edit out as long as I need to.
I will fight too.
Okay, let's see if Yuna can, because that's the bomb I want. Let's see if Yuna can kill these guys in one hit. Yes, she can. Sweet. Oh, maybe I can overdrive this guy. I don't think I'll kill him, but I'll do a lot of damage. Then maybe Auron can capture him. That's cool. No, wrong. Doesn't kill the bomb. I hope it doesn't kill him. Are you kidding me? Wow. That's 1.5 times. Yes, I can use cheer, I guess. Yes, I could use cheer. Let's kill this guy, I guess. No, I won't be able to kill him unless I get a critical hit, so he's gonna explode. Missed opportunity. The only thing, other thing I can do is get Auron to use his strong weapon, proper weapon, and deal more damage, and then change out into my capture sword later on. So let's put the Kotetsu on. Yeah. Hope we get another one. Wait, I should heal. Just in case. Okay, another opportunity. Yes. Yes.
Check this out.
Yes, that's what I want. I'll have... I know I can kill him. Let me switch weapons out. Beastmaster. I can cheer, which I can cheer. Make everyone stronger. So you know what, maybe I'll hold off and get some cheer on, and then I can attack the dude with Auron. We can attack once now, see what happens. Oh yes, I'm gonna get him. I'm gonna get him! Sweet. Only 80 left. I could do it with Titus.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
That needed more thought than I would have liked. Okay, let's equip you, Lulu, back with a no encounter. I really need levels for Lulu though, because I want her to get double cast. Which I can then give to Yuna. Alright, so we were able to get the remaining monster we needed from Mount Gagazet. Yes, that's what we needed. Sure, yes. We can just steal some stuff, so that's cool. Unfortunately, I left my audio on. Should we just run? Can I haste Riku maybe? Did I actually see what we got? This is good. Yeah, unfortunately I left my recording audio on, so there's double the noise. Oh well. Now what? Wait, I already got what I wanted to get, so I got everything from Gagazet. Good. Exit. So he's built like maybe 3 or 4 enemies. Wait, I can actually go check that again. Actually, so I'm gonna be heading back to Remiem Temple shortly. Okay, that was unexpected. Okay. Gambler spirit! Oh, sorry. Maybe Yuna can steal as well. Get one more. Oh god. So that was a counter attack. I didn't realize that was a counter attack. Oh well. I guess I didn't get the Gambler Spirit, no. Let's see how many monsters he's created. Original. One, two, only two. Original area conquest. Two. So I've got four. Another two more and I get a nice weapon. A nice item. So I might do that off screen, I didn't realize it's gonna be that. Quick. Berserk doesn't have many enemies, Glicka doesn't have many as well, so I might be able to do those really quickly. At some point. Mega Dungeon must have a few. They're all strong as well. Anyway, I guess this would be Zanakin? How come Zanakin isn't... No, yeah, Zanakin doesn't really have one. Oh, never mind. We'll find out what these two are later. This might actually be like a species conquest, area conquest, original. And, basically sin. Exit. Let me actually board the airship. I'll meet you back at Remiem Temple. So I wanted the Blossom Crown, which I got for getting every enemy, for capturing every fiend at Mount Gagazet. And in order to capture every fiend at Mount Gagazet, you have to capture every fiend at the Comlands first. So two areas really. And then we can do one more thing. Let's go to the back of this room. Use the Blossom Crown. It is a temple after all, so... Wait, that was it. So we obtained the Magus Sisters.
Why couldn't we see to stop the dreaming? Why did we stay on in Spira? We had forgotten for so long. We had forgotten to move forward. We had forgotten to change.
Defense fair. So yeah, like I said, when you go back to the temples, you get some dialogue from the fates. So yeah, that's really cool. I don't think there's anything else here. So this is same like Yojimbo. He has some other extra stuff to say. Anima didn't really have anything much to say, but then again, she had a more personal story to tell. But essentially, those three women form the Magus Sisters, and then we get to fight them.
If you've got what it takes to beat Sin, I should be no more than a bump in your path, right?
And then we can fight them. So the Magus Sisters are actually Belgemina's aeons. They're her final aeons, to be honest with you. And I think she might talk about this a bit later after the fight, if we win. I think she tried to use them to fight Sin as the final aeon through the final summoning, but she lost. So they weren't able to defeat Sin. And Sin killed all of them, basically. And that's why I guess the aeons in the temple kind of fell into ruin, this ruin or something like that. If that's if I remember correctly. I might not remember correctly. So I think my aeons are on full animation, and I think I might use Yojimbo to fight them first. I have a bit more money and hopefully that will be enough to fight them. I'm not too sure.
Very well. Before we begin,
we'll see.
Now, are you ready?
Thank you. Magus Sisters, and the cool thing about the Magus Sisters is that they're kind of like a full party. You can control
choose
all three
well,
independently. Wait, I have an overdrive? Oh, that makes things slightly different actually. Wow, Anima has so much health. Oh, your Jimbo, I like to. Man, I'd like to call forth your Jimbo, really. But I have an overdrive. Thing is, your Jimbo might die, so I have Mega Sisters as well. I think your Jimbo might die easily. This is a cool intro. I really like this intro. Especially with Yuna. Let's see. Let's go for 2-5. Kizashi. Whoa, that did good damage. Nice. Well, this is a really dangerous attack. Wow, he's got his overdrive full. Okay, let's pay him again 2-5, see what he does. Zanmato, sweet! That's what I wanted to see. Basically, Zanmato is a surefire kill. It's a definite kill.
Stop. That is enough.
So paying him 2-5 is really good.
Ah, you have made some progress, and for that,
I have to pay him a good amount. 2-5 is a good amount for endgame.
It may come in handy.
Shining gem.
Thank you. Perhaps you'll teach me again someday.
That's not possible. You have already surpassed your father. There is nothing more I can teach you. My work here on Spira is done. Time for me to go.
Send her.
Ooh, I can do nothing. Perform sending. Perform.
Yes.
It is in your hands. Destroy Sin and save Spira.
Obtain Wound Sigil. Oh, that's how you get it. Cool. So actually, the point when I was talking about how she says that she fought Sin and lost, I think she might have mentioned that before. Actually, maybe at Jose Temple or something, she might have mentioned that fact before. Yeah. That's why I think it comes to mind that she actually did try to fight Sin and she lost. And I assume the Mega Sisters would have been her final aeon, I assume that. But yeah, so that's the end of Belgemina's side quest. And we get the Mega Sisters from the temple, which is awesome. And I don't think I've ever actually seen Zanmato in my own playthrough, because I never usually get that far, but it wasn't that hard to do. Pay him a good amount of money and he does his job. Especially, I think it was also because his overdrive bar was full, so that helped as well. I might do one more thing before turning off this session, and that is upgrade the Yuna's ultimate weapon. Actually, I could use getting this chocobo race thing done, but because there's an item you get, a good item you can get if you get all 5 treasure chests in the chocobo race. But I might do that in my own time. I really got what I wanted to do. And actually, with Yojimbo and Zanmatu, you can defeat the Dark Aeons fairly easily. And so I might be able to show you guys the extra plot information at the temples if I can use Zanmatu on those enemies. I mean, there's only 2 really that matter. So, and then I can always sort of like reset the save and not have that as my primary save, so that I can then, if I ever wanted to in the future, fight the Dark Aeons proper. Legit, if you will. I just want to do it to show the plot points. So Zanmatu is a really easy win kind of mechanic, and you can use it against bosses as well, so that'd be really cool to see.